4 years, we have sat in these classrooms, made our memories, built our future, and prayed that we would make it. And we did. Our futures we worked so hard for are no longer a dream, and our future begins today. We couldn't have been happier when the countdown for our remaining days of high school started, and we couldn't wait for this day. We finally made it to the finish line that seemed like it was so far away. We remember this day as one of the greatest days of our lives, and it all happened so fast. Over these last 4 years, we've grown into new people, our interests have changed, and even our friends. But we all have one thing in common, we cannot wait to grow up. And we wish for high school to be over every day. Starting my junior year, I began my steps into the nursing field and started working the summer before senior year. All of my residents were so surprised when I told them my age, and even more surprised when I told them I was so ready to graduate high school. I don't think I went a day without hearing, "Wow, you're only a senior, well, you better enjoy it while it lasts." One resident in particular purposely told me this every day while she was staying with us. On her last day in the facility before going home, she told me to sit down and have a little chat with her. She began to tell me, "Lexi, you will be graduating soon and heading off to start your new dreams, but I wanted to let you know to slow down." I asked her what she meant by this. Her response will forever remain with me. "Slow down. Do not miss the opportunities because you were too busy wishing that it was over. Do not wish your life away. Do not wish for it to be over, because before you know it, 10 years down the road, and you're thinking, why did I let so many opportunities pass me? Because I just wanted to be done. My life will forever be changed by her and her message. I will never again wish for my life to hurry up because I just wanted to be done. Take every opportunity you can, and let the opportunity that you like to win no matter. As we get to high school, yes, we are ready for the bigger and better things, but high school didn't matter. It got us here to this day that we are celebrating because we finally made it. Props to us for surviving 4 years of high school. But in all this excitement of our big day, we forget that we didn't make it here by ourselves. There are so many people standing behind us, and we forget to thank them. And to show my gratitude from the class of 2016, I want to thank all of our wonderful teachers who taught us valuable lessons about life. Even though it seemed like we didn't care, we really did. For all your long nights writing our papers and thinking of ways to make lessons stick in our brains. To our parents who woke us up every day, made sure we kept our grades up and supported us through the long nights of stress and thoughts of we are never going to finish. Especially when they showed us disappointment, but instead encouraged us to do our best and life will be okay. And the rest of the faculty who dealt with us for 4 years and didn't give up on us, especially Mr. Metzger. My personal gratitude, I would like to thank my mom for being my number one supporter and being there every step of the way. My family for being the greatest thing and working with my hectic work schedule on the holidays. And to my friends for making my high school experience the best it could be. And a big thank you to my resident who left a lasting impact on my life. Thank you and congratulations, class of 2016, on all the accomplishments we have made to get here. And good luck on all of your future endeavors.
He is the son of Harold and Lisa Hatch. Jagger, as he's known to everyone in school, has been a member of the football, basketball, and track teams for the past 4 years, earning postseason honors in both football and basketball. He is a two-time national qualifier for Future Business Leaders of America and placed fifth in the nation in management decision-making last summer in Chicago. He will compete this summer in Atlanta in business calculations. He was a governor's scholar this year, and he also served as student council treasurer. Jagger will matriculate to the University of Kansas this fall, but he will major in mechanical engineering. Harold Hack IV.
Mm-hmm.
So,
4 years ago, I stood out there in the commons by myself, waiting for my first day at a new school. Many of you guys have lived here your whole lives and have gone to school together forever. And being the new kid, I was kind of scared and nervous. And I stood there wondering if I was ever going to make any friends. And that's the first and only time I've ever felt alone here in this community. I've never felt more a part of something. Before I start, I would like to take this time to thank my classmates for countless memories, my teachers and coaches for always pushing and guiding me down the right path, and I especially would like to thank the Pleasant Ridge community as well for accepting me with open arms. It has been said that Pleasant Ridge is like one big family, and standing here today, I can truly attest to that. To my fellow classmates, I would like to say that I am proud of what we were able to accomplish here in such a short time. Together, we have proven that it's not about the size of the dog in the fight, but the size of the fight in the dog. As a small school, we have been faced with limitations placed on us from others exceeding their expectations tenfold. Oftentimes, competing against much larger schools or many other kids than that, while we've represented our friends. Together, we have fought our way through the limits and barriers placed on us on our path to success, and here we are today. When reflecting on the accomplishments that I'm most proud of, I realize that together we have made a positive impact on both the school and the community. While many of us were involved in school organizations and sports, just as many of us are involved in organizations outside of school, we have truly learned how to affect the community and left a legacy that will remain here for all. Those of us who choose to remain here or return later will continue to help and make this community better. Most of us who choose to work or move on will bring the experiences and memories with us in order to make an impact on where we go. It does not end here, however. High school has provided us with many lessons and we will use them to continue to grow. Whether we are continuing our education or going straight into the workforce, we will take both the knowledge and skills we have gained in these past 4 years with us. As Pleasant Ridge graduates, I have full faith that we will represent the names of our schools in our respective fields. We will continue to do great things when we leave here today. Now, while this is an accomplishment and it's worth being proud of, it's only the beginning. The door to our high school days is closed behind us. Luckily, many more options have opened as we move ahead. Again, I would like to thank those who have helped to guide us through our high school. We couldn't have done it without the help of our teachers, coaches, and our families. You have all worked hard to shape and mold us into young men and women, and I cannot be more grateful. Congratulations, fellow graduates, and I would like to wish you good luck as you take this next step. Thank you.
Speaker Taylor Satry plans on heading south after graduation, and she will enroll in the University of Texas and major in biology. She's the daughter of Andrew Satry and Brandy Satry. Taylor has had a very active 4 years of high school. She's been a member of the cross country and track teams all 4 years. She's qualified for state and cross country 3 years. She's been a member of the cheer and dance teams all 4 years, serving as captain of the cheerleading squad. She's been a DARE role model and has been a part of FBLA, FFA, where she is president this year, RAD, and RSVP. She has also served this year as in the past as class officer, and this year she is our student council president, Ms. Taylor Satry.
You gotta go. Running through the heat, ignoring the mental voice telling you to give up, trying your hardest to not let go of your goal, feeling your strength slip away, but then you hear it. You hear them. You gotta go. Two of the most determined, big-hearted, and inspiring men are known for yelling this phrase. You gotta go. Though Mr. Hendricks and Mr. Marsh are meaning this in the sense of cross-country, it transpires through life in various ways. Those that know me or have seen me around know cross-country has been an immense aspect of my life for 4 vigorous years. Through the burning summer practices and increasingly cold races, friendships developed. Teammates, partners in crime, and fellow friends pushed each other through the daunting task of running your body past its comfort levels. With coaches constantly at your side, you feel a motivation greater than yourself. You do what you have to do for everyone part of the team and for yourself. These feelings can relate to high school or life in general. Sometimes you don't want to do that 6-page paper. Sometimes you want to just skip a couple of days because you don't feel like doing anything challenging. Or sometimes you want to totally give up on things because they've gotten too hard or you don't see the point in them anymore. This is the moment you have to listen to those 2 brilliant coaches. You gotta go. You have to pick yourself up, put on your icy hat, and sprint on. As a class, we have been tested. We have taken losses, including the life of a fellow classmate and friend, Alyssa Lane Hutchins. But what we choose to do with this indignation is what sets us up for our futures. We continue to persevere and reach for our goals and aspirations. We chose to cherish the life of a sweet and loving girl. We can remember the past and use the present for our futures. Even with the heartache and the setbacks, we as a class can listen to the voice. We had to go, and we have to keep going. We have to keep looking to the future and continue to remember why we are here. Every person has a purpose. I truly believe each one of us is here to fulfill a journey. We have to do everything in our power to succeed in our own excursions. This past summer, I attended Student Council Camp. We listened to motivational speakers talk about different perspectives on various things in life. Two things really stuck with me at that camp. First, one person gave strong advice on jumping at chances. When you want to accomplish something, do it. Jump at the chance to meet a new friend. Jump at the chance to try out a new activity. Jump at the chance to take on your dreams. When you jump at a chance, you can create endless possibilities. Second, we learned a saying that relates to people's emotions. Whenever you feel like life has handed you a bad set of cards, or whenever we feel like there is no way we can achieve something, we have to think about this saying, broken crayons still color. Think about that. What is the purpose of a crayon? A crayon is meant to make its own specific color. If you break it into two or even more pieces, it can still fulfill this purpose. If a human fails at a task or is hurt physically or emotionally, they can still fulfill a purpose. Let us all be our own bright and shining crayons. This will allow us to take on our own unique and self-fulfilling destinies. I will never be able to completely thank all of the people who have helped shape me into who I am today. The people who have aided my path have kept me inspired and motivated. Everyone has reiterated that I have to go on and continue my own endeavors. I thank each and every one of you who have been a part of my life. You have given me something to reach for, and I hope I can do the same for you. Take it from me. You just gotta go.
Our final speaker is Jared Smallstead, son of John and Tom Black, and Sean and Tracy Smallstead. Jared will continue his education at Wichita State University, where he will major in geology. Jared has been a member of FBLA and RSVP. He's been a class officer for 3 years, and this year serves as student council vice president. Jared played 4 years of football and baseball, lettering all 4 years in both sports. He also played basketball for 3 years, earning 2 varsity letters. Our final speaker of the day, Jared Smallstead.
All right, good afternoon. First, I would like to congratulate all of you. We made it, finally the day we have been looking forward to all years here. Before I start, I'd like to thank some people. First, my parents. Thank you for always being there and pushing me to be my best. Thank you all teachers and staff for guiding and teaching us, even if it wasn't very easy at times. And a special thank you to Ms. Hubbard, because without her public speaking class, I would have had to purposely get a B so I did not have to get up here today to speak. You all might have appreciated not having to hear one more speech at this point, but here I am, so I'll make it short and sweet. Also, thank you to the community for all your support of the 2016 graduating class. And finally, I would like to thank God, because without him, none of this would be possible. Now, today is a special day. Fellow graduates, turn around and look at all the support you have. With the unbreakable support of family and friends, anything is possible. We have supported each other through these 4 years like no other class ever has. This class has been knocked down by numerous things, but we have come together and proved we may get knocked down, but we get right back up again with the support of each other. Our class is one of the most elite classes in the history of Pleasant Ridge. At the beginning of the year, Mr. Metzger made us all watch a video by OneRepublic called Island. This video shows kids with cystic fibrosis making the most out of their life and living every day to the fullest. At the end of the video, Mr. Metzger challenged us to make the most out of our lives and have no regrets at the end of the year. Well, Mr. Metzger, I think we accepted your challenge. We gave life back to many old traditions and started quite a few ourselves. Breaking records, winning championships, and just being the best school around took a lot of hard work, but we did. Our class's accomplishments speak for themselves. I was going to read them all off, but the list was too so you're welcome. The challenge was to live and have no regrets at the end of the year. Well, Mr. Metzger, I think we lived. We were told we have a lot to live up to because of everyone always saying how great our class is. Well, we didn't just live up to what people said about us. We blew that expectation out of the water and took it to a whole new level. The class of 2016 will go down as one of the best classes in Pleasant Ridge history because of our hard work. As a class, we are not happy with a participation award. We want it all and we want to be the best. We lead on the field, in class, or anywhere we are by working hard. As the famous philosopher Joe Dirt once said, life's a garden digging, you gotta make it work. This class has made a great start on the garden of life by making the most out of this year. Without hard work, none of our accomplishments would have happened. I would not be up here giving this speech without her. Class of 2016, our garden of life has just begun. We have made a great start to this garden, but have a long way to go. I'm proud to call this class my class. Whether you're headed to college, going into the military, or going straight into the workforce, continue to do great things and go far and beyond expectations. Now, I'd like to challenge future classes to live and have no regrets at the end of your senior year. By doing so, you will continue the tradition of Pleasant Ridge being the best school around, while forming lifetime friendships with classmates. Exceed past just being a participant. Become great, make others great, and support each other all while being humble. Congratulations again, class of 2016. You are the best, and I love you all. May God take you far and bless you in everything you do. Class of 2016, keep on keeping on. Thank you.
Please enjoy the Pleasant Ridge High School Choir, directed and accompanied by Jackie Melton, as they sing a piece for us.
That's about that.
What this tape?
Oh. Yeah, we'll just tape everything.
Did you not record it?
Okay. Oh, I'm supposed to turn that off.
Oh, is REC supposed to go on? Get up there and do it again, Jared. This is my shot. I'm gonna
thank you.
Thank you, members of the choir and Mrs. Miller. Before we begin to hand out diplomas, if we have parents or family members who want to come down front and take pictures, you are invited to come down. Just keep me out of it. Mr. Coleman's Board of Education members, 53 members of the class of 2016 have met all the requirements for graduation as set forth by the Kansas State Department of Education and the East and Pleasant Ridge School District. I now present them to you for the awarding of diplomas. Kelsey Lorraine Beardsley. Brooklyn Ashley Billingsley.
I think Kid Cameron's going to do something.
Kelsey Lynn Bradford. Keith Bromley. Luke Anthony Cole. Richard T. Crumb. Duncan Demetrius Curry. Carly Claire Donald. Autumn Rose Gaynor. Chance R. Yager. Elizabeth Gould. Dustin Thomas Graham. Jacob Lynn Gum. Harold Jagger Hack the Fourth. Blake Robert Hadley. Allison Marie Hine. Morgan Elizabeth Hine. Bryce Landon Helm. Dylan Paul Herkin. Dakota Lynn Hill. Brennan Reed Hollinger. Nicholas Austin Holmes. Ronald Leland Jared III. Braylon K. Jurgensen. Caleb Nelson Karnowski. Christopher Aaron Kell. Cooper Harris Kesterson. Kilgore. George T. Kirkendall. Sarah Jane Lanter. Caitlin Marie Logan. Ashton Rose Lunsford. Cole Ryan Marshall. Grace Elaine McKinney. Connor James McClendon. Michelle Owens. Nicole Elizabeth Patrick. Keely Jane Redford. Susan Marie Redding. Jacob Elijah Rush. Taylor Elizabeth Satry. Jared Michael Schmalstein. Maggie Leanne Schwartz. Kirsten Renee Smith. Noah Andrew Tattershaw. Haley Allison Jean Traynor.
Glad I could take that picture before.
Avery Isaac Williams. Lexus Sierra Wright. Gabriel Connor Younger. Class of 2016 and our guests, please give us a couple minutes to get set up. I hope you enjoy the presentation.
Okay. 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 Okay.
Okay. Okay. Okay.
Okay. Yeah.
TV. You hear about it? It's still called Noah TV.
Yeah, didn't you hear about
TV? Yeah, that's it. I nicknamed it that when I coached a basketball team for Poindexter.
Oh.
2016. Congratulations, graduates.